Hi everyone, welcome to this video. In this video, I will discuss about the National Education Policy 2020. Here you can find all you need to know in detail, such as the exam pattern, that is how the exam pattern will change after this policy, the syllabus and the new system, that is 5+3+4 system. Earlier it was 10+2 system. And how will board exam will be conducted after this policy will be introduced. So watch this video to get all the information in detail. Before starting this video, I request you to subscribe my channel Information and Educational Videos to get such information in future. And do ask in the comment section if you have any doubt. So let's start with the headlines, that is the MHRD renamed to Ministry of Education, and the 6% of GDP, that is India's GDP, will be used on education system. Earlier it was only 4.6%, and all the academic exam will be now a skill based, that is no need to memorize everything. Now a student of age between 3 to 18 will have right to education. Earlier it was only for the student of age between 5 to 14 years. The e-content will be provided in 8 languages for all the students. That is, the study material will be provided online in 8 languages for all the students. And there will be a virtual lab in every college of India, so that a student can practice more. And the new system, that is 5+3+4 system, is introduced. Earlier it was 10+2. So watch this video till the end to get information about this new system. The next is, what is the 5+3+4 system? In this system, the student of age between 3 to 8 years, that is up to 2 class, will focus on the basic of education, that is how to play, how to study, how to sit. And a student of class 3 to 5 will focus on the basic of a study, that is how to study, read a book, how to sit, how to go to school and all the things. A student of class 6 to 8 will be introduced to the real education, that is the real subject will be start from 6. And one more interesting thing here is that the coding will be introduced to class 6 onward, that is computer language. A student from 6th class can now practice coding. Earlier it was only for the college student. The student starts coding after getting into the college, but now a student from 6th class can start coding. And the exam will be based on practical knowledge rather than memory based. The student of class 9 to 12 have the liberty to choose any set of subject that they wish to study. Particularly for the class 11 student, they are free to choose any set of subject. There is no foundation like science, arts, commerce. They can choose political science with math, physics and any other subject. Next is how the board exam will be conducted. The board exam will take place twice in a year, like JEE Mains. Suppose if a student fails to score a good marks in the first attempt, they have the choice of second attempt to get good marks. And there is no separation of a stream like science, arts and commerce, as I earlier discussed. A student can choose any set of subject, that is from commerce, arts, physics, they can choose any subject. And a continuous evaluation process will be done on the basis of practical knowledge, that the marks that a student will get of a particular class will not depend only on the final exam, but depends on the whole year activity, that is the practical activity. And the project work will be introduced from class 6, that a class 6 student will now introduce to the project work. and the 0 to 5 class teaching will be done in regional language, so that a student, that is the child, can understand the content in a easy way. Next is the information related to the college. What will be changed for a college student? Now a student can left college at any stage, that is after first year, second year, third year or fourth year. Suppose if you left after first year, you will get a certificate and you can rejoin anytime later if you wish to complete the course, or if you don't wish to complete the course, you can leave the college. If you left after second year, you will get a diploma certificate, and if you wish to rejoin and complete the course, you can rejoin the college. And similar for third year and fourth year. College student too can change any, choose any set of subjects. That is, the student are not bound to a study a fixed amount of subject. They can choose any set of subject they would like to study. They can choose dancing, singing or other co-curricular activities as a subject. You can choose dancing as a particular subject of your degree. And the most important thing here is, now the government will decide the fee structure of private college, that the private college can't decide their fee structure by themselves. So that's it about the national education policy. Hope you get the right information. If you like this video, do subscribe and share my channel. Thanks for watching. Keep watching for more information.